It looks a bit like something out of a fairy tale. One of those places, yeah. It's just a beautiful place.
Just say, imagine one of the most beautiful lakes, surrounded by mountains, crystal clear water.
Pine forest beside you, and then you've got this picturesque lake in the middle of what can only be described as paradise.
It's like it's its own little sort of magical kingdom that seems, it's like you're going back in time.
It's a place of community. It's a place where people come, and in this instance, we're talking from all over the world, to spend some time in. And that is no different to the one down the road in Birmingham or Amsterdam or everywhere's got one of these. It's just this one is at the top of the tree. You know, it's the best park lake in the world.
The weather cold, the weather so chill, chilly, willy, penguin feather road, cause I'm sipping pro. Yeah, that meth is pro, promethazine, yeah, stepping stone. Oh, they acting up, get your weapons wrong. They only killing time, another second gone. I heard your man at home, now you melatonin, but you acting
up. It was
young.
My idea to come here originally. I've wanted to do it for a couple of years. It was off the back of that Eurobanx trip. We've heard so much about it and we've seen the videos and the clips, and it's such an iconic moment. If you ask anyone on our YouTube, like, what's the best Nash moment? Lake Bled, Riders in the Storm.
This has probably been one of the greatest carp experiences of all time.
Lake Bled's one of the things that people kind of do think of when they maybe think of myself. That time at Lake Bled, that was my favourite moment ever. Yeah, and it was also my favourite. It was incredible. So to come back 6 years later, with the best bunch of lads. It's been as good as, if not better, than when I came the first time around.
Okay, she giving me love, but it fucked my energy up. Every time it's finna be summer, only got the memories of us.
And looking after us for the week is a true friend and local angling legend, Gaspar. There's not many anglers in the world who know Bled as well as he does. Videographer Barn headed down to the lake in front of the hotel early that first morning to capture the sunrise and was greeted by Gaspar, who was already playing a decent carp, after his rods had only been in the water for no more than 20 minutes. Shortly after Gaspar netted his prize, a load of the lads came down to celebrate the capture and soak up their first Bled sunrise.
Yes!
Hey, catch one, hey, catch one. Big one.
Brent, you are.
Nice.
Very, very excited.
As I say, no one knows Bled as well as Gaspar does.
Hello, it's me. This week we're at Lake Bled.
The levels of excitement across the team were already high, but having now seen what amazing carp the lake holds, we were all mad with anticipation to begin fishing the next day. With big smiles on our faces, we set off for a lap around Bled's 5 kilometre shoreline.
It looks amazing here. Like, whatever you saw on Eurobanx 2, whatever you've seen from films, other films here, it's just nothing compared to when you're actually here. It's just incredible, such an incredible place. And I think a few people started to get ideas of what they want, but we need to do a few more laps till we 100% know what we want to do tomorrow morning. So now, like I said, a few beers, we're waiting for broken down Blair, yeah, the birthday boy Blair to arrive. We had a bit of car trouble yesterday. It's his birthday today, so I'm sure we'll celebrate that at some point later on, but just excited to be here. Yeah, such a cool place.
Thank you, bro.
Are you loving it?
Yeah, it's incredible.
The best place ever.
Having broken down a few hours away from Bled the night before, thanks to a small mistake of putting petrol in their diesel engine, Max, Alan and Brad had some catching up to do, so unloaded their van and set off on their own lap of the lake.
With it being Alan's birthday and our first night in Bled, it seemed only right to head to a local bar to discuss tactics for the week.
We'll just go wherever Alan is.
We'd agreed prior to the trip that fishing in pairs would be the best way to tackle such a large venue, and also to keep things as social as possible.
Where's Matt?
Gone, mate.
All right.
Where?
You did have 2 beers.
we'll just test you guys and just see who's
catching the mic.
Exactly. Yeah. Oh, we'll jump on your swim then.
Yeah. Every time we're caught, yeah. Essentially.
Ollie's going to have you casting on his spot at about half six.
Yeah, right on by time, Ollie. Something to look forward to.
A deeper right over your spot. Let's just check the depth on that one.
There's some fish down there, Ollie. Yeah.
Good morning, chaps.
Good
morning. How are we doing? How are we feeling after last night?
Better than expected, let's put it that way. Yeah, it's actually adrenaline, I reckon, you know. Lake Bled, getting the rods out for the first time.
I think we're going to fish the woods. I think that's our plan. We saw quite a few there yesterday. They've been, Jeremy's been fishing, they've been catching during the day as well. The only problem with it is you've got to reel in by six, I believe. So that's the only annoying thing, because it does seem like there's a lot of night bites here. But it's done fish, we've seen fish, so we want to go and start.
Because it's days only, I don't know, maybe people won't fish it as often because like they have to move and like it's lugging your gear around Bled. Who knows? So it might be a little bit of a productive area, but we're not gonna jump to any conclusions just yet. But we're gonna do our best to angle well, and hopefully it won't be too long before we have a big Bled carp in our hands.
Hot dog anyone?
What are you learning, Henry?
I'm watching.
Taking it all in. Hey, whoa.
We're in a rush, Henry. Stop being a all this night.
Right, gentlemen.
Good luck.
Godspeed.
And speed.
This seat is really tight on the old bonehead.
You might be wondering why the lads are using bikes. Well, fishing at Bled comes with several strict rules. Daily bait limits and day-only fishing with absolutely no bivvying up allowed or even the use of a stove. Fishing begins at dawn, which at this time of the year, in late October, was around 6 a.m. The circumference of the lake is around 5 kilometres, meaning getting to your swim while carrying all your gear and bait for the day can take some time and is somewhat of a struggle. Tom and Dan chose to fish on the far side of the lake off a popular and well-known point. Henry and Alfie made for the opposite bank, deep in the woods. Ollie and Vusen opted for directly in front of the hotel, whilst Max and I began on a large pontoon boardwalk area at the far end of the lake.
How are we doing, guys?
Very good. Look at this.
It's gone from like pitch black, hasn't it, to not pitch black in like 5 minutes. And now we're nearly about to cast in to Lake Bled. If you'd said that to me even two years ago, I'd have said, you're crazy, mate. Look at that. My horizon marker is the church at Lake Bled.
OCD and me, I love feeling the lead down just tonight. It's hit the bottom and everything's kicked away. So you can still achieve accuracy by doing so, but all I'm doing is casting the dot spot to the marker float, so I don't have to be guessing, you know, where depending on the depth of water and how far you're casting as to how short you clip the spot up. I cast to the marker float, then I know I'm exactly on the money, to be fair. It's probably the best way to do it when you're fishing in such deep water. So I'll get that out next to the marker float in the clip. I've just done that. I'm gonna have another cast, make sure it's on the money, and then we're fishing. Well, we're gonna be fishing accurately at least anyway.
Godspeed.
Crossing the other side of the lake, Tom and I had opted to place ourselves in a highly popular area on a large point near Villa Bled. We'd seen quite a few fish showing at a moderate distance, around 110 yards, and I figured that fishing two rods tight on one spot would increase our chances of a bite if a group of Bled carp found our bait.
So it is pretty deep.
We followed a similar approach to Alf and Henry, using marker floats to gauge the correct distance to spot to, before tightly baiting one spot with a few kilos of scopet squid boilies and tigers, then fishing two rods close together.
Alan and Max had spent since sunrise hoping for a bite on the pontoons in the southwest corner of the lake. But since seeing them showing close at first light, the fish had moved into deeper water. So the lads decided to move to where they could see fish showing to the right of Dan and Tom.
So we've decided to drop into the sort of right-hand side of Dan and Tom. We saw some fish out here last night. We heard them, but they were quite long range. Hopefully, I'll find myself a nice spot out here, get ourselves off the mark with a bled carp, and give ourselves a bearing on which to act from for the rest of the week.
So Mark and I are paired up for the week with Gasper.
Who actually is Gasper? Alan and Ollie caught Gasper poaching their private garden while they were filming Eurobanx 2 and instantly became great mates. Gasper has been carving at Bled and has been a huge friend to the Nash team ever since.
Yeah, so we're opposite the casino. What have we got in front of us here? A good area?
It is one of the known big fish areas, so to speak. A lot of big fish get caught from here, oftentimes over a bit of bait.
Yep.
So that's also what we did. First thing in the morning, what I did was I got the deeper out, had a look, just to get an idea what's in front of me, roughly. I know there's not too much to look out for. In the end, I settled for a depth of around 14, 13 and a half meters. Put a marker rod out, clipped in, and then I set all my rods to the same distance. Saying that, I felt the let down. So that means in such a big depth, there's quite some swing back, like the lead is coming towards you. So that's also the reason why when I started spombing, I didn't spomb them all on the same length. I gave like one rep or even two reps at times, and then I took one or two reps from my initial distance. So it's like literally just dots of piles, little piles of bait everywhere, and then I sticked around like 3 to 4 kilos of oilies over two. Usually I use a boat whenever I can. So yeah, the spombing this morning, I feel it in my arms. I'm not used to it. Yeah. We're just not used to it, but we're doing our best and hopefully we fluke one or two out.
No, I think like the baiting approach, it's like trying to stop a herd of cows, isn't it?
True.
So one pile of grass won't stop them, but a field of grass, yeah, they might have a little mooch on that. So we want a herd of big bled cows, don't we?
We're looking forward, yeah.
Good. Following the same approach as Mark, I used a throwing stick to create a spread of boilies around my rigs, and it didn't take long for the fish to home in on the bait, drop down to investigate.
Oh, take. Ollie is in.
Take too long, did it? How long have you been fishing? 2 hours? Mark's still baiting up out there. I don't think it's a big one. But the pressure's off.
He's cool.
He's a nice one, huh? Lovely.
Lovely.
That's a small one, yeah. Okay, what a cool character, huh? It's funny, he's got like a kinky tail as well. It's a really cool one. Anyway, first carp from Bled of the trip. As you can see, it always draws a crowd. Best thing about this place. Okay. Yeah, you want it? Okay, we put it back now.
You wanna Thank see? You.
No problem. Okay. Goodbye. Yes. Love Bled.
Out went the rig to the same spot as before, and then Mark and I kick back to relax in the early evening sun.
Things stayed quiet across the lake for the remainder of the evening. This didn't matter though, as we were all surrounded by such incredible scenery and great company. As me and Henry were in the northwest corner by the woods, the fishing was restricted past dusk. So around 6 p.m, we packed up and moved nearer to the hotel, which was just to the left of where Ollie and Voosen were fishing.
OK,
Okay, here we are, the evening spot. We would love to have stayed where we'd done the day, because just as we had to pack up, fish started showing, but you can't fish after 7:15 up there, so we had to come down where you can fish into the evening, and it's looking really, really good, which is why I'm speaking a little bit rushed, because we've just seen a few show. We want to get the rods out as quickly as possible. We know that it's done quite a few bites recently, so although it's not been mega prolific today, it has done bites recently. Gasper just told us that now's the best time to fish for them, so who knows, this could redeem what has been a relatively slow day on the fish front.
Gasper told us that pretty much as soon as night fell, that's when we could expect a bite, so patiently we waited. And he was pretty bang on. It couldn't have been dark for longer than half an hour. Boosin was into a fish.
Playing what feels like a pretty good fish. There's something coming up. Looks all right. Good fish.
Oh, that's a lumber. That's a good one.
21.5.
Really happy with this one. Big fat mirror. Actually, my first big mirror from this lake after I was able to catch a nice 20 kilo coming in the spring. So, yeah, let's see what left us out there.
While Mark tied up a new rig, over on the other side of the lake, Dan tentatively played his first bled carp.
And I'm absolutely shaking. My knees are honestly, my heart's beating so fast. I don't think I've ever been so nervous with carp on the end. I can't really believe it's gone. Please, there he is. Let's have her in, Tommy.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And that right there is my first bled carp. First night, first blood, first social.
Good fight, 412.
36, 37 on the dot.
Well done, Dan.
Well, there she is. Off the mark. I've got three or four lads behind the camera absolutely goading me because I shouldn't be here. I should be the other side of the camera. First three socials I was. Luckily, I somehow swindled a spot fishing for this one. And yeah, we've just been sat there with Tommy. We just actually spoke to the camera, saying how excited we were. And this lad come along and said, yeah, 8 till 11, that's when it kicks off. He'd been gone, what, 10 minutes? And yeah, I got the bite. 37 pound. I put out quite a lot of bait to start with today. Scopet squid, the new sweet candy tigers, a little culture duck bait. Did the job. So I am well chuffed. Well, would you bloody believe it? We're in again. And she's only just started pulling back. I'm a little more chilled now. That first one, my knees were knocking. I was very, very worried. But now, a little more, I can enjoy it a bit more, I think.
You're bigger than
now.
Yeah. Quite a bit bigger, mate.
Sick. 666.
Right,
thank
quickly.
You, guys.
Well, back out.
Yeah.
Quick.
Whilst I recast my rods, hoping for the bites to keep coming, the fish appeared to move across to Tommy's swim. And so, the action began for him.
An empty net, soon to be filled. Go on, Tommy, first bite.
Not in the net yet, mate.
Nervous?
Huh?
Nervous?
I was nervous.
Feeling big?
You were smashing me out.
We're a team, Tom. We're a bloody team. How was that? For absolute Lake Bled buzz. First night, and we've smashed it. Like, I couldn't have dreamed they'd go this well.
Not been a bad start, has it?
Nah.
46 pounds and yours 43.
Not quite as big, but
90 pounds a cup.
In a couple of hours, do you know what I mean? It just happened, it just turned on. The clock's chiming 10:30 behind us. We got to go in a minute. But like I say, if I didn't catch another one a week, over the moon, one moment. Me and my old mate, Tommy Trinder.
But we are going to try and catch a few more.
Oh, aren't we? Aren't we just?
Well done, mate.
Well done, Tom.
Tom and Dan slipped back their incredible brace, and before I knew it, it was my turn to feel the weighty pull of a Bled carp.
So no sooner, the boys just slipped back two 40-pound commons. This one's gone. It's just chugging now. Everything in this deep water feels like a monster. So, yeah, I'm shaking a bit and it's my first Bled bite.
Knowing what lurks in these depths, I agonisingly played my first fish for over 20 minutes. Eventually, it rose to the surface and lit up by our head torches, it became clear it was a large fish.
Oh my god, mate, the one it is! Me and Curly here were like, alright. It was kind of probably totally unnecessary to get in, but if it had just fallen off there, I'd have never ever forgiven myself. Oh my god. Head gone. And Tommy's in as well. What is this place? Is mad. Blown away. Cheers, boys. I'll do, won't it? Well, more than do, to be honest. Mwah. Sweeps.
Let's see. Well,
it's another big one. Who'd have thought it?
Just when we thought things couldn't get any crazier, the left rod that went earlier with a 46-pound common, re-clipped it up, re-chucked it again, and it's gone again. Not only that, Max, who's sort of a couple of hundred yards up to my right, towards the casino, was also playing one at the same time. He's got an absolute monster. Makes this one look small, which it certainly isn't. What a great first day at Bled. What a carp, and what a backdrop of Bled. Literally bucket list complete. So whatever happens for the rest of the week, I do not care one bit. Oh my god, fly home now, just like I said. Thank you, man. Thank you.
tank.
I ain't got long boy.
My top piece of advice for coming to Lake Bled, don't worry about the fishing, don't worry about bait, don't worry about spots, location. My best bit of advice would be spend 150 euros on an electric bike.
The way the fishing works in terms of it's strictly no night fishing, you can't camp on the lakeside. You've got to go back to an apartment or a hotel every night. Means that in the summer months, you know, in those peak sort of daylight hour months, you're getting up at 2:33 in the morning and you ain't getting back to bed till maybe 1 or later at night.
You know, when you wake up and that alarm goes off and you feel terrible, you feel rough, you feel beaten, just remember that literally in 45 minutes you could be sat there with the rods out relaxing and then you could be catching a 60, 70 pound carp. And if you can focus on that and always remember the reason why you're here in the first place, because how often are you going to get to come here? Not that often. So make sure you always remember that, and I'm sure that'll keep you motivated.
As we put bait out the previous day, hoping it might draw some fish into the area through the night, Henry and I headed back to the woods. Again, the plan was to fish here during the day and then move across to in front of the hotel in the evening to be ready for bite time.
Day two has arrived. We've got back in the same swim. Last night was a late one. Tommy had his bite, his last bite, like 10 to 11, which meant we ended up getting in bed about 1 in the end, once we'd done his fish and Max's fish. And then we're up at 5 and we're round here. But hopefully today's a little more chill. We don't have as much to do. We've found the spots, we know the areas. We're hoping it's a case of just rinse and repeat, you know. As you can see, Tommy's just putting a few spots out in case they have cleared out anything we put in last night. Maybe we'll get a morning bite, but yeah, we'll just sit here for the day and hopefully come nightfall, it begins to kick off again.
Got him.
Oh no! Oh no! No! What's that dude up there? Look where he's gone!
After doing a bit of marker work yesterday, we discovered that the bottom out there is, there's not a lot going on, you know, it's sort of firm silt, very smooth, very flat. So I don't need to fish a pop-up, so I'm opting for an 18mm Scopex Kid Wafter. That's what I had the two bites on last night. That coupled with the fact that because of the depths, 46 feet plus in places, I just don't think the pop-ups are doing their job. They're not being as effective as they would be in, say, 8, 10, 12 feet of water due to the pressure. So I've gone with the Wafters. There's no need for a pop-up anyway. There's no weed out there. And yeah, it's doing the job so far.
Worst places to be blanking.
You won't blank. An easy lake.
Oh, stop saying that. That doesn't make it any more comforting. It just makes it even more like, oh my god, if I don't catch, that's even worse.
I'll put a lot of pressure on you over the course of the week.
I might crack.
No, you won't. You're a big boy, you can do it.
I know we'll get one at some point, it's just until I feel like I know what we're doing is going to result in fish. I can't really feel, not relaxed, but not comfortable.
There's worse places to sit, not do a lot, so I'm not complaining one bit.
Business.
That's disgusting. It's disgusting.
While Dan and Tom ate their boiled eggs in the shade, Alfie and I enjoyed a pint in the sun at a restaurant meters from our rods. And Mark and Ollie similarly took the quiet period in the middle of the day to rest and relax. As the lads in all corners of the lake made some final preparations for the evening ahead, it was actually Alfie who was rewarded next for his efforts. Not quite the Bled monsters he dreamed of, but a good start nonetheless.
Well, right on cue this one. Just as you didn't think it was going to happen. We've only got about 2 minutes, I think, to leave before we have to head out of this swim because it's days only. And yeah, I've opened my Bled account. It's not the certainly not the biggest carp in Bled, but it means an awful lot to me to catch a carp from such a historic venue. Yeah, it's really put a big smile on my face. The perseverance has paid off, and I'm looking forward to getting down to the next swim and trying to repeat the process. Don't film this, I just rolled my ankle on the swim.
What happened?
I ran down the hill, but I just landed on my ankle sideways. Not what you need when you need to push fight around the lake.
I've never met anyone who, as a grown man, makes that sound so often.
Even though Alfie's been sort of 50% at times due to injuries, which I'm sure you'll hear about, injuries and illnesses, all we can do is pray for him. Pray for Alfie. Start hashtag.
The success of the previous night, where things had kicked off just after 8 p.m, had us all eagerly awaiting and hoping for the same. Both sides of the lake, pretty much on the hour at 8 o'clock, things went from 0 to 100, and it was Tommy's night once again.
And right on cue, just as we lost the light, Dan and I were sitting here. They started showing, as they did last night, lovely 36-pound leather. I baited a bit more tonight. I thought I'd try and keep him in the swim a little bit longer. It's only about 8:30, so we've got plenty of time for another one. Happy days. Day two at Bled.
I slipped that one back, got the rod straight back out, gave the spot a few more spots of bait, and immediately I was in again on the same rod. My thinking was that a constant application of bait drifted down through the deep water would draw the fish back down onto my spot and keep the bites coming. As I played my third fish of the evening, I was left with no rods in the water. So in a great team effort, Max, Alan and Dan all chipped in. They were wrapping up my rods and spotting for me, all whilst I prepared fresh rigs ready to cast out.
22.5, yeah? Yeah, I'll stick at 26.
Me getting in on the action, the carp had turned up on the other side of the lake too.
Just like yesterday, nothing all day. Still, no fish showing, nothing. But they start to eat as soon as it gets dark.
Well, that's a really cool one. The length of it.
Just like Tommy, my fish came in quick succession. I didn't have to wait long for my third bite of the evening.
15 kilos. They fight so hard in here. It's hard to tell.
Thank you, bro.
Yeah.
Kicking off.
That was another nice common, and my fourth bite of the night came shortly after.
Is it a mirror? No, it's a common, Gaspar. Well, I'm not complaining. Yes, what a result. What have we got? Same again?
a bit bigger.
Yeah, he's got a belly.
Well, fourth common of the evening, definitely the biggest of the bunch. I'm going to say this one's over 40. Either that or I'm getting weak in my old age, but yeah, lovely fish. Lovely, lovely fish. Lovely.
Ripper.
The old arm's getting a workout. It's not been bad enough, throwing, sticking. Not complaining, you know, it's the best kind of pain. But we've worked for it. Thank you. Perfect. Wow, crazy evening. Bite number five.
As 11 o'clock neared, over on the other side of the lake, Tommy managed one more bite to top off an incredible evening.
Oh. Yeah,
yeah, you're in, Tom.
Good effort, boy. Right, what's just happened? In the last hour or so, I've had four bites. This is bite number three of the four. Beforehand, I managed a 36 pounder. Whilst I was getting that rod back out, I had another one. That one, the common that we've just put back, that was a 30 pounder. I had another small common, and then this mirror, which is 44 pounds. We've still got about an hour's worth of fishing to go. But if I don't catch another one, I'm not too bothered, because this one is a right biggie.
That ended up being my last fish of the evening, meaning a tally of five in total. Awesome couple of hours shared with the boys. At 11 o'clock, we packed up and headed over to Ollie Swim in front of the hotel to luckily catch the end of what had clearly been a manic evening for them as well.
Ollie, Ollie! Go!
Just one more leg.
Yeah, machina! Another mirror!
So I had a bite about 10 minutes ago. With like 20 minutes left, got to leave it in the net just in case we get another one between us. And the other rod is ripped off. So, yeah, a nice way to finish what's been quite an action-packed evening. Feels quite heavy, this one, actually. All of them. Haven't got a good look at it yet. You just see like a big shape down there.
Oh, here it comes.
Yeah, boy.
Big one. Really big fish, mate.
This was really. Ooh, yeah. That'll do, bro. What a great end to the evening. They've just got bigger and bigger as the night's gone on. Literally bigger and bigger and bigger.
They're massive. They're really big. Can't stop catching them. That one on the left is enormous. This place is mad. Let me get involved.
Well, after a run of four commons, I've finally got a mirror, and what a lovely one as well. 21 kilos, beautiful fish. It's not even the biggest one either. I've got an even bigger one in the net. It's been a busy night down here for me. Mark's had a bite as well, but Tommy's also been smashing it up the other end, so after a quiet day, it's come good in the hours of darkness. Epic night. Big one.
Thank you.
the size of that.
Yes, Gaspar. Well, I listened to the King of Bled's advice, didn't I? Listened about rigs and about location, and yeah. Woo! Thank you, man.
You're sure?
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, bro. Thank you.
This was actually my biggest fish of the trip at 56 pounds and my biggest bled carp. Couldn't ask for much more than that, and it was wicked to have the whole team around to share the moment with.
That's it.
Yeah.
Well done, mate. Well done,
Ollie. Cheers, boys.
Well done, mate.
Nice one. Yes, good boy. Sick.
If I could punch anyone in the face, just... it'd be Henry Lennon. I hate him so much. I love him, but I hate him. He's like a brother. Do you know what I mean? You know that brotherly rivalry? Like, I just love to smash him in the face. I knew he could take it because I've got noodle arms and he's got like a granite jaw. But like, just me and him are just constantly bicker. Like I say, it's a brotherly love. I love him, but I don't know how to explain it. He's just a dick.
Good morning, another early start, but change of location this morning. Actually fishing where we did the night last night, put quite a bit of bait out and they didn't seem to move on whilst we were fishing. Hopefully they've moved on in the night and we can catch one as they're still hanging around this morning. We're a little bit further down from where Ollie had that pretty incredible run of fish yesterday. Hopefully we can get involved in that. Gasper's done really well in the morning as well. So it just made sense to make the effort, get down here, fingers crossed for a big carp. You may notice I'm by myself this morning, that's because sadly, Alpha rolled his ankle yesterday when he was going up and down the wood swim that we were in. Alpha's a proper warrior, so for him to be out of action, it means he's really done a bit of damage. So I'm just hoping it's nothing too serious, he's not broken it or anything, and within the next sort of 12 hours, the swelling goes down a bit and he can come join me, because it does seem like this could be the spot for my first bled carp, and hopefully Alpha's really big bled carp as well.
A little bit more with the sarcasm.
Because
it actually did sound like you were saying he is a warrior.
Yes! I was just doing a piece to camera about how hopefully this is going to be the morning I hook into my first bled carp. And I'm in. And it's beasting me a little bit. I've been waiting for this moment for quite a long time. I am massively nervous right now. It's mad how long you're just waiting for this moment, and then when it comes along, you just don't feel like you prepared yourself for it at all. And even at that sort of distance, it's taking a lot of line. Oh, yes. That's a bit of a lump as well, isn't it?
Good, isn't it?
Oh. I was really just thinking, like, it ain't gonna happen again. And it has happened. Look.
Well done, mate.
Cheers, bastard.
Oh, yes.
That is enormous. Look at that.
So rough. How big do you think it is?
54.
I can tell you, it's bigger than that, mate. It is 50. Keep it as still as you can. 58. 58.8, I'll give you.
58.8, yeah. I'll take that.
58.8, mate.
I'll take that.
58.8.
Hang on, mate. 26 kilo.
actually bad.
When I first got the bike, it like ripped off. I thought, oh, I've just been a wimp. Like, I've got to play it properly. And then it popped up. I was like, nah, I'm not being a wimp.
I'm staying out.
Yeah. This is a proper car. Oh my god, look at the size of that. This carp is the realisation of a dream that I've had since watching Eurobanx 2, since I've seen Alan and Ollie tear this place apart. I think everyone wants to come to Bled and catch fish like this, and to finally do it with all the boys from work, it's like the highlight of my carp fishing life, I'd say. Just look at that carp. Enormous, old character from probably one of the most beautiful places I've ever fished in my entire life. Such a special moment, and it's made all that effort. It's made this even more worthwhile.
Well done, mate, well done.
Oh, cheers.
That is massive,
it's
mate.
Massive,
that
isn't it?
So it's big. Huge.
Yeah. Are they open now?
Yeah.
Alan now being the only member of the team to have not caught a fish, his day unfortunately proved to be quiet on the fishing front again. However, Vusen and Tommy did manage to bag a small one each, by Bled standards.
I've laughed, belly laughed so much. I don't know whether it's the throwing stick or the laughing, which my
our buddies heard.
Yeah, I mean, that's one thing I should point out, that although there's been a lot of sitting about, we haven't been idle. We've worked pretty hard, actually, to prepare the areas. Baiting is hard work, you know. The baiting is hard work. Fishing with much more boilies than I'd normally fish over, but it's what you need to get a bite here, to stop the shoal, to get the fish down feeding. Totally the opposite, polar opposite to my normal kind of fishing, but when you come here, it's obvious that that's what you have to do.
First time in 15 years. I feel it, mate. My body is hurting.
I feel that, bro. I feel that. I don't use one much either, so yeah. Between the pair of us, we're not like the biggest stickers, but we've gone for it, haven't we? We've gone for it.
Yeah. We stick to the plan, literally.
Yeah.
Every evening, every morning, the bait goes in, and so far, we're not doing bad.
Pretty good, man. Pretty good.
So
fingers crossed it's going to work again tonight.
Pretty positive.
Yeah.
Really, it felt like we were just waiting for that special time around 8 p.m. when we hoped things might kick off again. And it did. Pretty much to the hour, just the same as the day before.
As per usual, nothing all day. Well, Tommy had one.
Yeah.
Tommy had one, but quiet all day. It gets dark. We wait an hour. They begin to show. Bam. Right on cue. Bite. Little drop back. And after watching Tommy haul them last night, it's nice to be connected to one.
fishing the net, buzzing, looks like about a 30 pounder. I did think it was a bit bigger and that's why I was a bit quiet when it started, but buzzing with that. Like I say, after not having anything last night, I've had a rod ready, propped up, because it was hectic last night, you just got to get back on it. So I had one ready to go, fresh rig, wrapped up, just waiting in the trees. As soon as that one's hit the net, I've picked this one up and I just need to zing it out.
In exactly the same fashion as the night before, the fish once again seemed to move across to Tom's swim, and so the action began for him.
Tell you what, Tom, you could play that one for a week by the looks of it.
That's a good one.
Get back out. Get the rod back out. Go.
Now. Quick. Quickly. Go.
It's happened again.
This place is just mental.
It's literally, you would sit here all day thinking there wasn't a carp in here, bar the odd show, which 9 times out of 10 is a bloody trout.
Could
And then as soon as it's dark, you start hearing them, and right on cue for the third night running, the bites have just started coming. That is number 10 for me, which I'm very, very happy about. He's a fat one. Not quite as big, but...
I'm not going to waffle too long. Tommy has returned with the Tom Show, slaying it. He's got two massive ones in the net since I landed this. So without further ado, let's see what Tom's got.
44 and a half.
20 kilos.
Fish number one of the brace that I had not long ago. 43 pounds was it, 44? It's another 20 kilo fish for me. I think this is my fifth now over the magical mark, fourth, sorry. And the one that followed just shortly after, I think is about the same size. He might even be a bit bigger. Another hectic evening here at Lake Bled. And here's number two of the brace. Slightly smaller, but still a very respectable 42 pounds. That's 2 40s in the space of sort of 30 minutes. And we've still got about an hour or so of fishing. So without being too greedy, might be a chance for one more. For Dan.
It's hard work getting all this bait out. Everything started to cramp up. It's worth it for a big one though.
With no wind, I thought, why not try something a little different? So I filled up my baiting pole with a generous helping of large seed mix and Scopex squid boilies. Pulled my rig out some 80 yards, by far the furthest I've dropped a rig using the baiting pole to date. The bushwhacker has changed my angling massively in the last few years, and more than anything, it was just a challenge, and I wanted to be able to say, I caught a Bled carp on a baiting pole.
First Bled carp on a baiting pole.
Big moon tonight, hopefully big carp. As the carp appeared from the depths of Bled, it was clear that perhaps it wasn't a bigger than we naturally hoped it might be. However, as with the night before, that first bite, the beginning of yet another epic night. Striking 10 o'clock. Better get this rod back out quick.
Oh, that's another bite.
How's that feel, Mark?
Really angry, essentially.
It's a good one, huh? Sure.
Really?
Oh look, here's my one. Get the net under that quick. That's a big comment. That'll do. Lovely jubbly. Thank you.
It's a nice one, that, isn't it?
Yeah, boy. Yes, brother.
I wasted no time in poling out my rigs 80 yards once again. As I was doing so, Henry's rod burst into life.
Might sound a little bit out of breath, that's because I was just helping Ollie put a lead on it, one of his rods. He's getting a bit of carnage action happening over there. Helping to get his rod back out again as quick as possible, and mine's just ripped off.
How does it feel?
Feels alright. I find it really hard to tell in this deep water.
Oh, it's a big one.
Yeah.
Yes. Well done, lads.
It's another big one, isn't it?
Let's have a look, shall we?
Big dog. Oh, mega carp.
Look at that, mate. That's a big one.
Mega carp.
That is massive.
You boys, are you ready? Come on, you know, man.
As yet another carp found its way into my net, so ended an amazing night for us in front of Bled Castle at what truly is an unbelievable venue.
And that is the clock striking 11, bringing an end to proceedings for this evening. And we've got three whackers in the net, well, four actually, Henry's got one as well. So after a slow start to the evening, it's turned out to be pretty epic. Mark and I are going to be weightlifting.
Heavy lift.
Final bite of the evening, right as the clock was striking 11. Perfect timing. Oh yeah. Well, I never thought I'd be using a baiting pole at Bled, let alone getting double takes. But that's exactly what happened. Cheers for your help, Mark.
Thank you for letting me.
Oh, crazy. Crazy.
It's a real luxury problem, isn't it?
Lovely times. Oh, that's... I once just gone and chilled. Look how big it looks in the water. Imagine how big a 70 pounder looks.
Good.
Yeah? Yeah.
It looks sick.
It's cool, isn't it?
It's so cool.
Start the day with a 50 pounder and then I end it with 1 ounce short of 50 pound. It's a pretty good day in my books. This place just is incredible. We just sat over with Ollie as he was tearing up with the baiting pole, like an absolute one toner. And this really cool, a character I'd say, definitely, with the cool scales and its fat ass basically. But there's another amazing carp from this amazing place. Probably one of my most favourite days angling.
We only like catching small ones from the river, Henry.
Oh yeah, but when you're in Bled, you've got to change it up a little bit, haven't you? Cheers.
Bloody hell, he was ready, wasn't he?
Yeah, he wanted to go back. Oh, mega. Nice.
We do have a good laugh in some amazing places, and there's a great camaraderie, a family to it. So, you know, yeah, those individual fish moments are nice, the parties are nice, those funny moments in the office.
I always laugh when I'm down at the farm, because there's usually an interesting meeting. There's always a reason why I'm there, so there's something to take part in. And then there's all the boys in the office, and there's always some good banter going on, and I always love that. Yeah, you feel the heartbeat in that. It's like that building is alive. It's carp fishing. That building has seen more carp fishing than any of us. So just being there is inspiring and funny. There's always some laughter to be had. The farm is a place that I always look forward to visit every time, every single time.
On the morning of day 4, the rest of the lads enjoyed a well-deserved lie-in. It was clear to see the fish had been moving in after dark, most likely staying all night to clear up all our free offerings. I'd been determined to get a bite in the early morning period, before the sun hit the lake and it all went quiet again. So I cycled round to the swim at 4 a.m. so I could have my rods in the water just on dawn. And only 20 minutes after having them out, one of them was away.
44, I reckon. Bang on 47.
Not quite a PB then.
47.2.
47.2. This place, man. This place. Mega. Yet another 40 pounder. 47. I don't know how many me and Tom have had between us now, or let alone how many the boys have had between them, but. That is mega. First day bite. Actually lost one this morning as well. So maybe we can have a few more today. I'm over the moon with that. Mega old Bled carp. Don't know what else is happening around the lake, but it's gone quiet here. And today I had actually always set on moving my spot, which kind of sounds a bit weird considering I've had five bites now, four fish. To move spots, especially as I've been building into it, might sound a bit weird, but there's method in my madness. I'm coming a little bit shorter. You know, I was fishing, not mental range, but over 100 yards. And really what we've worked out is don't need to be. It goes down to about 14 meters down there, which is about 45, 46 foot deep. And it's just a bowl, and I think there's no spots as such. I just need to bait. So why not come shorter, be more accurate with the baiting, dropping that dot spot on a lot tighter area, putting the rods a lot tighter together. I'm very confident that they're gonna come to the bait. I had this plan this morning. Everything I can, the 5 kilo allowance, I'm going to deposit that on this shorter spot now. Just all round, be a lot more efficient.
To the left of Dan, Tommy and Max both spent the morning doing the same, spotting out the 2/3 of their 5 kilo bait limit to then leave, ready for the carp to come across later that evening.
Following their success the day before, Henry and Alf chose to ignore the wood swim and fish in front of the hotel for a full day again, similarly spotting out a considerable amount of scopet squid in preparation for the evening.
Having spent 3 days pretty much sat in one swim, I was eager to get round the lake and do a bit of sightseeing, so I popped in to see my old mate Alan for a catch up.
I've loved it, man. The first 3 days, I was genuinely having a social. I think you know me better than anyone, Al. I'm probably one of the most anti-social anglers there is out there. You know, even if you look back at the previous social films, I never wanted to socialise with anyone. Remember that time in Amsterdam? I organised a big social and then went fishing. But yeah, honestly, these 3 days, yeah, granted, I've not caught anything, and that might be part of it, but I've enjoyed my time seeing all the lads and sharing the moments and helping out where I can. And yeah, it's been really good fun. Now I'm kind of in fishing mode, but
you've got to catch one, haven't you?
It'd be nice to catch some, yeah.
Oh, that's a big one.
Be nice. I've come back in here again. Again, we talked about it last night. I've done a couple of days flitting around. I fished those boards two mornings. I've done an afternoon down on the boats to our right. And if I carry on like that, I run the risk of not being a proper carp angler, and then definitely run the risk of that kind of I told you so scenario. And that'd probably come from you. You're a good one for I told you to sit it out for a big one. Or definitely Gaspar, you know. I've only seen him a couple of times, but he popped round yesterday showing me the little pup, and he said to me, Alan, you must stay here. And when you've got someone like that telling you that,
it's working the spot a little bit. Like, yeah. Saying to Alfie, like, we put a lot of bait in. He's taking a lot of bait to feed. Like, ultimately last night I caught him with the pole wave and not much bait. But like, there's been, I don't know, 40 kilos put out between Mark and I over the last couple of days.
It's hard work.
Because Mark and I had had a nice lie-in that morning, unfortunately, our swim in front of the hotel had been taken by two Dutch anglers. So we moved to the other end of the lake to test out a new spot. And within no time at all, Mark had managed an impressive beast.
Don't fall over.
Catching a nice one on the first night, I'd now spent a couple of days blanking, so decided to move to a spot near Dan and Tom. I kept the bait going in consistently all morning, and my efforts were rewarded that afternoon as a flurry of action came as the carp appeared over my bait.
Am I just getting it being weird because I'm just so used to seeing, you just get no sense of scale anymore, do you?
No.
Yeah, it's only a small, it's not a massive one. Oh, it's a nice carp though. It's got a cool scales on him. Oi, oi. It's not, is he?
No, he's still a good 30.
Yeah, mate. Well, got me 30.
Well done, man.
Cheers, mate. Thank you.
Trouble is, I haven't got a sling.
Oh, that's a bite.
It's a double take.
What?
It's a double take. So we were just about to get the other fish out, and we're getting it all sorted and everything. And this rod has absolutely smashed off, but then oddly enough, the rod next to it has gone as well. I'm looking at the line angles when Henry's picked it up, it's actually a double take, but not like a double take, like you're playing it and then halfway through the other rod goes, as in they went at the same time. They got hooked at the same time, yeah. So can't quite believe it, to be honest. So this 31-pound mirror was the first of a manic afternoon. Managed a double take as well, when it all went absolutely crazy over the bait. And I get to have my dream photo taken with that church behind me on the iconic Lake Bled. Bucket list moment for me. And I can't wait to see what the next couple of days brings on this new area that I've just started baiting.
Once again, it was another great night in this area of the lake, with Max landing a small mirror and Ollie and Mark enjoying continued success in their new area. And this time, it was Dan's turn to enjoy the action, catching three massive carp while Tommy spectated.
Ooh.
Big enough,
I don't see it.
That's big for you.
What do you mean for me?
He's quite a big one, isn't he?
They're all big.
Guys! Guys! The cameras are on me, can we be quiet? God's sake.
It's not a £10.
It's really starting to kick off.
Jesus Christ. A catfish pole. First one we still haven't got out because Max had a bite, the boys had to run off. That looks like a 40 pound common. I've got one in the net here, which could go 40, a mirror. The rod went back out on the spot and what, 10 minutes and we're away again.
That's a big one as well.
Yep, that's another big one.
That is a real big one.
Heavy than that.
Yeah. 56 dead.
Oh, well done, mate.
56 dead.
I did not think it was that big as well.
Nor did I.
And there it is. 56 dead. A Lake Bled beast. One had been coming for me and Tom. And I got it. I don't really know what else to say. I know I've got two others that I actually had before this. Both look 40 pound plus, but then when this rolled into the net, couldn't have done it without Trinder. Tommy.
No way.
Thanks, mate.
43 and a half. 43 and a half.
The average size in this place is mental. Mental.
Suddenly this one feels quite light. Oh no, it hurts again. 45 pound.
Word on the WhatsApp group is Alfie's got one over on the other side. I know he's been struggling for the last couple of days, not just on the fishing front, but with a sprained ankle. So, well done, Alfie.
That's tight, that drag.
Oh. Sorry, I'm not saying much because it was like a very long time coming. We were just sat up at the bar, last orders, just having a nice chat in quite comfortable conditions today. Very mild. Getting to that time of night where the bites have been happening, or at least to my left and right. And Ollie just sent a message on the group chat saying, best of luck, lads, hope it happens, bite time soon. 5 minutes later, well, I said, thanks, mate, hopefully tonight's my night. 5 minutes later, ridiculous. I've just sprinted on my bad ankle, but I can't feel anything because my heart is, the adrenaline's got to me at the minute, but just playing nice and calm, but it's a very, very, very hard fighting fish.
Right here.
Well done.
Oh, 40 pounder, isn't it?
Oh,
yes. Come on. Come on. Yes. That's still yes. Wow, look at that. Getting angry already. Now, this has been longer than I would have liked to have been. Every night I think that it was going to happen. Obviously, the guys to the left and to my right were really having a good time. And as happy as I was for them, seeing some incredible faces, Henry had a fish of a lifetime, and it was so nice to be part and share that experience with him. And we were just sat up at the bar, having a nice talk, just as it was last round, and my receiver has gone into meltdown. And finally, I can say I'm another part of the team who's caught a 40 pounder, 46 pounders, something ounces of
incredible looking Bled carp. This is a real nice mirror. Look at that, putting the dorsal fin up as well. I'm just I'm ecstatic, absolutely ecstatic. Incredible venue, unbelievable carp.
How have you seen Nash change since you joined?
It's just exploded. Like, I would have thought a lot of businesses with passionate, enthusiastic, motivated people involved in it. Everyone sort of wants the same thing, and that's to strive to do a great job, whatever department they work in, take pride in that. And when you take like that and levels of expertise, that passion for angling and carp fishing and catching carp, and you put a lot of good people in the mix, yeah, the business has just gone mental. From when I started, we've employed so many people in the last, well, yeah, since I've been here, 15 years. It's just grown, and it's just the most incredible company, because fundamentally, we all love going fishing. That's why we're here. A very expensive work trip to Lake Bled. Because you deserve it, that's why. It's certainly an endurance. Another late night for me. Knocked the flask up before going to bed and got up at the crack of dawn again, cycled down here. The cycle down really isn't that big a problem. It's getting back up you don't look forward to. But it's finally come good. I've got a bite, I've got a fish in the net. The lads were a little bit later getting up this morning and I don't blame them. Videographers have gone above and beyond, like ridiculous amount of work. Dan and Tom are shattered. I haven't even seen Max yet. But yeah, got a bite, off the mark. It's been very, very difficult. Not entirely sure why, can't quite put my finger on it. Sat here questioning pretty much everything, but maybe it was just time. Maybe it was just about sort of sitting it out and waiting for them to finally come over me. I don't feel it's gonna kick off into some monumental Bled carnage at the moment, but if I nick another bite or two in the next sort of day, I'll go home happy, man. Morning five, a lot of bike riding, hill climbing, walking, and lack of sleep. Had a good smattering of effort, and I finally caught one. The boys have absolutely been tearing it up, like super proud of them. I've got to witness so many of their captures, some personal best too. They really have done a sterling job. Don't know why it's been so difficult for me. Maybe the first couple of days, I wasn't giving it 100%. Certainly the last sort of 2 days, I really have grafted. And it just wasn't working out, and you start to doubt things, your rigs, the area you're fishing over, have I put too much bait in, all those things whirling through your head. And yeah, it was just a question of time, really. I needed to give it that little bit longer, and I got one. It's a special one, you know, the first one on my trip, but nowhere near as special as witnessing all those other lads catch. The brace of commons for Dan and Tom, Max is big and Henry's big, and I weren't there, but I got a massive hug that evening. Seeing Ollie over by the town, absolutely rinse it, and it's just been the most ridiculous trip, and we've still got a little bit left. I'm gonna graft just as hard as the previous days to even get a few more.
You look so hipster, I like it.
Oh my god!
Do the Spider-Man thing.
Hey, well done.
Thanks, mate. How was it? A 43, a 45, a 47, and 56.
That was a good day, mate.
It's a good day.
That was a very good day.
It's a nice spot here, though, isn't it?
Lovely, yeah.
Is it annoying with the public and that?
No, more annoying in our swim, because they're a bit closer.
Yeah.
And if anyone gets too close, I just stare at them.
Gasper told me the real big is just going to sit on the bottom. Move again, it's move. Just when it's sat on the bottom, he says the 30 kilo plus is just going to sit there.
Hey! Oh.
Get in there.
It is a good one.
Oh, I was convinced, man.
I was convinced it was a giant.
You look disgusted by it.
Of all the decisions made by everyone across the week, arguably the best was made by Max when he decided to move swims down to the left of Tom and Dan. The first part of the week had been really slow for both of us. Max was now settled into his new spot, and with a decent area located at a comfortable range, he was now flying and getting bites consistently, even in the day.
What a scene, Nick. We're playing a carp, out in the background, massive cloud base. The Lake Bled church, like, you've got to be in your element, really. I'm just shaking at the moment. Like I say, it could be a pop-off and it's £29. It could be completely wrong, because you can be in these situations, but I've played a few carp out of here now, and there's only two that have been like this. They're just different. Come on, you big, beautiful common carp. Hey! Fantastic, mega. That's a nice one. That's a proper nice one. So, been wading my way through some smaller carp. Bit of a shoal came in yesterday. I had some manic afternoon, catching some really nice fish up to sort of low 30 pounds. But this morning, I've managed to catch myself this epic 45 pound common. A little bit of ghosty in him, but I'm absolutely made up. The new spot as such that I've been moved to. The baiting, the fishing, the casting, all that's been worthwhile. And them early mornings getting to the swim just so I can have an absolutely epic fish like this.
Crazy carp. He definitely wants to go home.
Who's going to get the first run tonight, Tom?
Me.
We've got to the stage where it's not like, are we going to get a run? It's who's going to get the first run. And then typically, that's who's catching all night long, and the other one just sits there, flaccid. What's been your favourite part of the trip so far?
Getting a couple of bows kip yesterday afternoon.
That was your highlight so far?
Yeah.
Tommy, you just sat on your phone?
Well, if you said something interesting, I'd respond.
It's a bit of a crazy one, huh?
Go on then. That'll go. Oh, I've been waiting all day for that one, Mark, haven't you?
We were just saying, literally, we were just talking, weren't we? I can't believe you haven't had a bite on
yes.
that. You talk that one into the net. It's a nice one, man.
Really made up. It was a long wait today. I think this one was worth it.
Mate, I got up the earliest yesterday.
By about 15 minutes.
Still.
By about 15 minutes, the first time all week you've done it.
Oh, what, all 3 days? That was the third day because I was. You motivate me. The reason I fish with you is because you pushed me through.
Aw, that's nice.
Yeah, it is.
I wish I could say the same about you, but frankly, you frustrate me at times. However, it has been a fun week.
So here we are again. It's another good one. Have a look.
41, 42.
Because you've seen it all before, another night shot of a 40. Tom just said, I'm just going to put it back. But most importantly, because it's raining and he doesn't want to get really wet, he's left his waterproof trousers in the van and he's not getting wet for a 40. Isn't it, Tom?
Yeah.
The low pressure and heavy rain had now properly switched them on in front of Max, and his rods continued to produce the goods. First, a mega mid-30 common, and then whilst preparing to get that rod back out to the zone, his other rod bust off with a much bigger 48 pound mirror. Yes, Matt, smashing it.
What a day. Like, can't put into words the fishing that I've enjoyed here.
And that wasn't to be the last. With 30 minutes left to go before the rods had to be reeled in, there was one more Bled monster to come to Max's net. What a day. Great angling, bro.
You have to keep going. Yeah, this is what it is. It's all at stake is like, is catching a fish of a lifetime. And I've already caught a 56 pounder. Like, that's incredible. But there's a little bit of me that would just love to catch a 60 pound Slovenian carp from Lake Bled. And if that could happen, then I'll be on cloud nine. Oh my God. Look at the size of that thing.
You smash new PB.
Yeah, again. It's a beast, Gasper. It's a beast. I don't know how big that is, but that's a good fish, mate.
Full of boilie.
Full?
62 and a half.
No way.
62.4.
What? 62 and a half pounds.
62.4.
Oh my God, mate. I'm done. Thank you, bro. Oh man. Not in my wildest dreams could have I have ever expected to catch a 60 pounder from Lake Bled. But here in my hands is the most awesome creature. I'm absolutely ecstatic. The week has gone beyond my wildest dreams. The rain's tearing down. The lads have all been getting bites because it's amazing weather. And this is the culmination of 2 days of graft spotting relentlessly, getting up early. I can't put into words how happy I am. Look at that, mate. That is out of hand.
Big ton?
52. Felt really heavy.
Well, another mad night. I've just witnessed Max catch an absolute monster 62 pound. Tommy's had two tonight. This was my third bite. Embarrassingly almost, that we were having a look at them and going, it's about 40 pounds, and just dipping the net and letting them go back. Such is the stamp of fishing here. This one came just before 11. It was absolutely hammering down with rain. Went in the net. We were sorting another fish out I had. And again, I was a bit like, I just dipped the net. And I took a second look and thought, it's quite big. It went 52, so I'm glad I got it out. Mad place.
He does a lot of fishing, he's a very capable angler, but if I hadn't been next to him, this session, I think he would have been to be honest. Nah, I'm joking. He's brilliant. He fishes some tough lakes back home, big pits. I think he want me to mention that.
So I don't care what Alan or Ollie, Tommy, Henry, anyone says, this side of the job is a lot easier than that side of the job.
He always says to us that it's easy what we do in being this side of the camera. All you got to do is fish.
All the finer little details in fishing and just looking at everything in a different light, that's what Tommy's good at. So for me, yeah, Tommy's the boy.
If there's someone you need by your side to keep the morale high, and keep everything going, you know, not put you on a downer and keep lift the spirits. That person is Dan. So yeah, it's been great.
Morning, last morning at Bled. Me and Dan came round to where the action was last night. And to start with, Dan wasn't fishing on his spot because he put 10 foot distance sticks instead of 12.
Put the distance stick in the wrong hole. Got my rods out nice and early. I'm sat there all content and now, yeah, I was up first. Beat Henry to the swim. Henry's like, why are your distance sticks so short? I've been sat there for an hour fishing like two rod lengths shorter than I should be. Redid them. It was gone already, so.
So thankfully you've got me here to point things out for you.
I think Henry's the one to thank for this.
But yeah, Dan's in pretty much. You said it didn't even set the bobbin and it gone.
No, I was just setting the bobbin base.
Solid.
Nah, it's coming, but look at the rod tip.
Oh, don't you worry about that. You got bullet mono on?
We got bullet mono. It's your white belly on it now.
For God's sake. Ooh, big dog.
Who, me?
No. Can steer it around, Dan. Where are you going? Dan. He's in the net, Dan.
Netted by Henry Lennon. I thank you.
No worries at all. It's an honour.
There's my reward for getting up this morning. £44. You kind of have a bit of a warped perception after a while of how big they are. We thought it was like 38, 39, but a little bit bigger. Mega carp, mega place.
As it was our last day at Bled, and considering many of us had been fishing far apart in different areas of the lake, myself and Alfie came out to fish near Dan and Tom's swim, with Ollie and Mark enjoying a lion before joining us later for lunch.
Dan wasn't the only person to enjoy some early morning success.
In the valley, the mighty valley, Henry's chasing bears. Alfie's battered, Alan shattered, and Ollie's still in bed.
Had a second big one of the morning. Definitely a boily muncher, this one. Both of them were on boilies, squid cultured hook baits, slip D rigs, and I've actually started seeing a few fizzers now, much, much shorter than where I'm actually fishing, basically on my spod spill line, which is quite significant because I'm not very good for the dot spod. So I'm going to zip one of those long rods in, fish it short for the next hour or two before spending the afternoon with the boys.
Tried and tried yesterday, yet again. Caught a big catfish and then nothing else materialised for the rest of the day. And the night for that matter, and yet again, I went home fishless. Well, kind of all around me, the boys were smashing it. The boys were smashing it. Max had a 60 and numerous other big ones. Got to the point with Dan and Tom, they were just slipping them back, they'd caught so many. And yeah, I went home having not caught, but I cracked back on this morning. Up that hour before first light, round here, and like yesterday morning, I had a bite, and then another bite, and then ended with this one. So yeah, £47, another one of 41, and one about £20. So finally, it's starting to come good. I'm gonna go and sit with Max for the rest of the day today. All the boys are coming round, we're gonna have a bite to eat, and basically celebrate, without doubt, the best social ever. Walking out in the rain again.
He still got it.
We're gonna catch a carp today.
The rest of the morning saw little action except for a lot of spotting and hanging out by the brollies.
It's not worth it.
At lunchtime, Mark and Ollie came round and we gathered in Max's swim to have a final day social. Beers, burgers, and just see everyone. Because to be honest, we don't get the chance that often as a whole team.
Thank you.
Well done, sir.
Thank you.
Good angling, young man.
As we celebrated an awesome week, Henry's rod, a couple of swims over, tore off. And so we all headed round in hope for a big one, with all the team present.
What a way to end that would be.
Oh, that was the most exercise I've ever done after a bottle of whiskey, like finishing a bottle of whiskey.
He had about two shots to finish it.
I'll leave it out, will you? That was at least 2.5.
How is it won't be getting in at this point?
He's
going to
go get the
bend that rod or what?
Feels all right.
This is a £20 common, I will never live this down.
How's it feel, Henry?
Feels good, but they're all telling me that it doesn't fit. It doesn't look like it feels good. Carp, that's common.
Yeah, they are. Oh, it's 50 pound common!
This is what I wanted. This is my target all along. Yeah, target achieved, boys. Yeah. I honestly, for a long time, I was thinking they can keep chatting because I know this is a big one. I was just like, they were like, there, make as much fun as you want. A £70 is about to pop up. Oh, he's bigger than 15. He might be 60. Any venue I go to, the first aim is always to catch a small common. So I'm glad to have finally done it. All the last nights here at Bled. I did think it was a really big one. The boys give me a load of stick. I was just thinking, yeah, you make your jokes. A big one's about to pop up. So when this guy popped up, a little bit embarrassing, but it's been a great week, great social, and it's fantastic to end it with a tiny common.
Come in now. By this point in the week, we'd all seen plenty of action, and with it being the final evening, it was only right to let the videographers deservedly have a turn. And of course, true to form, they had it off.
Next one.
We made a sort of kind of made an agreement if it kicked off like it had previous nights, we'd let the other guys have a go. You know, everyone's caught a carp already. We've all caught. We've all had a lovely time. So it was really nice to see Tone, Sam, Brad, and Barn all catch a carp. That was lovely. I think that was my highlight. You know, we're all here together. It's nothing personal. This is not our personal fishing like we do back home. It's the name suggests. It's a social. We've had a lovely time, so why don't we all catch carp, you know? That's what it's all about.
Yeah,
that's a big carp.
That is a massive carp. Well done, mate. That's a sick fish.
It don't get any better, does it? Legitimately, don't get any better. It's been the most amazing week. And now to be able to sort of pass on, and it is a small amount of gratitude for the hard work these videographers have put in. Letting them have a little bit of fishing, it's incredible.
Yes, Sam! Yes!
Haven't fished with Alan for ages, haven't fished with Basil or Vusen, you know, so, and Gasper, you know, Gasper's a legend. He's really looked after us and yeah, we've had so much fun, it's been brilliant.
Because we missed out on 2 years of not having shows, not going on shoots together. So it was just lovely to catch up with everyone, spend some time. Haven't seen Ollie in 2 years, so we had a lot of catching up to do, and we did. Just lovely time.
Close to the end, remember, we made it.
Oh my God.
Fishing front, I had a pretty dreadful week. It's not actually that dreadful, it's just on Lake Bled standards. Didn't catch many fish, but it was still the best social for me ever. Loved it, absolutely loved it.
I've never had fights like it off carp, and yeah, it makes for it to be even more of a leg shaking moment. You like lose yourself completely. Like my head was completely blown by it all.
My highlight was definitely my PB. I mean, I know I'm so excited for this film to come out, just like watch that back and live that back. I actually said to Bomb as it was happening that we're so lucky that we're being filmed here, because not only obviously that I get to go here in the first place, but secondly I've got that moment there forever. Keep looking back on it, it's just a bit more than a photo, and just an amazing experience.
It's been an unbelievable week, and obviously we've been behind the camera the whole time,
and it's been fantastic to see everyone hauling and catching some incredible carp. So it's kind of getting on the action on the last night, for us at least, has just been fantastic. Unbelievable, we've got 51, 45, and 41. Ridiculous.
Theme and the aspirational content around coming to such an iconic venue, and the fact that I'm stood here now at the end of an amazing week, I personally never ever thought it would happen. So it's an incredible place and I've had an unbelievable time.
Unreal, what a way to top off a ridiculous week.
Absolute soldiers, lads, in the main team.
Max, jump in.
Come on, mate, can you get
together? Like, we've all got such different characteristics, everyone's a different person, you've got these different characters in it. If we were all the same, robots of carp fishing, it'd be boring, but you've got all these different guys and that's what makes us such a strong, unique group of lads who will be my friends for life.
So you're not sick of them?
Some of them.